Hello, namaste, pranam. Today's video is on Hinduism versus atheism. And I think there's a lot of confusion around the whole concept of atheism and whether it's a part of Hinduism or is it not a part of Hinduism. So I wanted to dedicate one video just to that. So the first thing I want to say is that atheism or modern day atheism is mostly an outcome of a response to monotheist traditions. I don't know if I can call them traditions, but definitely monotheist religions. So monotheist religions, so like Christianity, like Islam, any religion in which there is only one entity, only one God, like I'm using the word God specifically here, there's only one God who is considered to be the almighty, divine or whatever, those religions are not able to find an audience or a following with a lot of people who are just not able to accept that concept, and they become atheist, right? They deny that there is something like one God somewhere. Now Hinduism is completely different from these monotheist traditions. See, the thing is that what happens when atheists start moving towards Hinduism, when they reject Christianity, they reject Islam, for some time they become atheists, right? Because they're rejecting that ideology altogether. But when they start moving into Hinduism, instead of actually opening up to what is the concept of divinity in Hinduism, and I'm using the word divinity instead of God because there is a very profound difference between the two. When they start opening up to Hinduism, they just limit themselves to their old ideas of atheism a lot of times. And I'm just sharing what I have seen happen to many people. They get so stuck in their identity of being an atheist or in their so-called discovery or realization of being an atheist or a sense of pride in being an atheist after rejecting those kind of ideologies which don't satisfy their logic or the intellect, that they're not able to move further from that point to actually understanding what does Hinduism really say about divinity. And they just stop with that and they start, you know, rebelling in other aspects of Hinduism or accepting, rejecting whatever they want of Hinduism. But they don't move forward to really explore what does Hinduism say about God? What does Hinduism say about divinity? So what I want to first say here at this point is that just simplistically drawing an equivalence between being an atheist in response to monotheist religions and being an atheist in response to Hinduism are two drastically different things. And atheism by itself, I'll explain further what I mean by atheism in response to Hinduism. Atheism is not a part of Hinduism. Now, this might ruffle a few feathers, so I'll just go forward to explain a little bit. Now see, Hinduism, the ultimate truth. Now I'm not saying that this sampradaya should say this or that sampradaya should say that. Whichever sampradaya shares whatever they want to share, it's up to them. But the ultimate truth of Hinduism, which is reiterated in the Vedas, in the Agamas, in the Upanishads, in the Bhagavad Gita, the same truth, because truth is truth, right? It is the cosmic truth. It is not my truth versus your truth. It is what is. And the cosmic truth is that everything is divine. Not just everyone, everything is divine, right? Isha vastam idagum sarvam yat kincha jagatyan jagat. I've repeated this verse many times in my previous videos as well. And I repeat this verse because it is the easiest to relate with that. This idea is revealed in many verses, in many scriptures. But this is just the most easiest, simplest expression of the truth. That's why I keep repeating it. There's another verse which is sort of like a Mahavakya also. Not really a Mahavakya, but it's a very profound verse, which is Brahmavid Brahmayam Bhavati. Knowing cosmos, you become cosmos. Right? So this truth is expressed in many ways in Hinduism. So what I'm saying is that in Hinduism, everything is divine. Right? Now, atheism rejects divinity. right? That's a thesis of atheism. Now, if you apply it to Hinduism, that means you're rejecting the whole possibility of divinity at all, right? You are, what you're essentially doing when you say you are rejecting the idea of divinity, as it is explained in Hinduism, what you're really doing is you're rejecting the idea of enlightenment itself. You're rejecting the idea of moksha, because what is moksha? Yes, moksha is breaking away from all your karmic cycles and getting liberated. But what happens? How do you become liberated from your karmic cycles? By realizing you are divine. Because only someone who is divine has no karma. That is enlightenment, right? So enlightenment itself is getting established in that ultimate experience of I am divine, Shivoham. Now, when you say you're an atheist, what you are saying is you're denying the possibility of divinity itself. It's not about denying ki God exists here or God exists there. You're saying God does not exist anywhere. So what are you doing? You're reducing everything to just matter. To you, everything is matter. Even human beings are matter to you. Essentially, that's what you're trying to say. Because what is it that makes human beings like alive? What is a soul? The soul is Brahman. Brahman, is that is the Jivatma, which is a manifestation, or I don't know what is the right English word for it, but uska ek ansh hai, right? The Jivatma is an ansh of the Paramatma. And there is no separation. So what you are saying is basically in contradiction to some of the very basic core ideas of existence itself. So when you deny the possibility of enlightenment, what else are you doing? You're denying the whole idea of reincarnation itself, right? So you can see that the ideas of atheism, the ideology of atheism, when mapped to Hinduism, is absolutely becomes not just ridiculous, but it is absolutely contradictory to some of the core tenets of Hinduism. What is the idea of karma? Karma is like, yes, you gain karma when you cause pain to others, anybody, any living being. When you cause pain to them, you earn karma. When you make others' lives easier, you reduce karma. That is karma. And when you get enlightened, you lose all your karma, right? Or rather, I should put it the other way around. When you exhaust all your karma, you are ripe for enlightenment. Now, if you are saying you are an atheist, how does karma work out then? Because karma does not exist just in isolation, right? It fits in a bigger scheme of things. So as you can see, like, it's in contradiction with every core tenet of Hinduism. If you start just simplistically transferring your ideas of atheism to Hinduism and then also saying you're a Hindu. This is why I've always said that there is no such thing as a Hindu atheist. Atheism does not become a part of Hinduism just because you are saying so or just because you want it to be so. Yes, maybe you are an atheist after rejecting Christianity or Islam or some other religion, but if you really want to start exploring Hinduism, you have to be a little loose about that tag of atheism. That's all I'm saying. In Hinduism, atheism is a stage, it is a stepping stone towards inquiring into the nature of divine. It's not an end in itself. That's what I'm saying, right? Even devotion is one of the ways of exploring the nature of divine. So if you are starting off as an atheist and you're saying, okay, I'm rejecting the idea of God exists only in one place, then, but that itself is not an end. That's what I'm saying. That is one of the, one of the aspects, one of the points in your journey. That's not an end. You can say that, okay, I reject this part of it. Now let me explore what really is divine then. What is divine? Another thing, this is just an expansion on what I said before, but it's a very important thing that, see, in Hinduism, the whole point is to make you realize more and more that everything is divine and getting established into you to the point where you experience everything as yourself. And all dharmas, kama, moksha, everything in Hinduism is designed towards that, whether it's rituals, whether it is yoga, whether it is meditation, whether it is pilgrimage, everything is designed towards that. To move you towards exhausting your karma, to move you more and more and more towards moksha, towards enlightenment. Right? Atheism means you're reducing everything to matter. So that means there is no God anywhere. So what does that mean? What kind of a thought current does that generate in you? It means you're denying all possibilities for yourself. It's not about whether it's offending me or it is offending somebody else. It's basic denial of your higher possibilities. What will inspire you? Okay, for some time, maybe something may inspire you. But essentially, after a certain point, you will hit a wall. Because that idea of denying starts applying to you also. Like, you know, human beings are not so complex also. If you develop certain thought currents as a practice, as a default response to say 10, 11 things in life, you will apply that same thought current to yourself as well. It's not just about what you're applying to me. What you dump on me is what you're going to dump on yourself at some point of time. So when you keep denying divine in everything, you're obviously denying the existence of divine in you. Right? And it's not just about denying the existence of divine in you. It means you're denying your higher and higher possibilities. You are just living a mediocre life, or you're rather forcing yourself to live a mediocre life. Right? That is the bigger problem with atheism. And this makes you give a knee-jerk reaction to some things which don't fit into your logic. Because your logic is just one of the ways in which you try to make sense of things that are happening around you. But the things that are happening around you are not limited, not defined, not based on your logic. Things are happening as they're happening. That is cosmic intelligence. Your logic has its limitations because your logic is not making things happen. Your logic is at best trying to grapple with or trying to grasp the things that are happening. Life is not limited by your logic. And atheists forget this a lot of times. They are so obsessed in their logic, in their minds, in their heads, that they forget that there is something called consciousness. And when you say that you are a Hindu atheist, what you're basically doing, I'm sorry to say this, but you're cheating yourself. Because you are just trying to build a comfort zone around you where you're saying, oh, I am a Hindu also and I'm an atheist also. You're not taking the next step forward into breaking your ideas and actually exploring. Like, it's not so hard. You can just read the Upanishads. You can read Bhagavad Gita. You can pick up any scripture. It will tell you the same thing because it is the cosmic truth. It's not my truth. It's not my opinion. It is there, right? So these are some of the things which are very confusing for many people because they've not really given much thought to it. If you live life as if everything is matter, what are you becoming? You're becoming materialistic. And if you don't understand how that materialism is not Hinduism, then I don't think you have really given a serious thought to what ideology you're sort of parking yourself in, right? So it's not just about, so many people keep saying that, you know, are you like some sort of an authority on Hinduism? Well, first of all, I think I am. Second of all, it's not about me trying to declare whether I am an authority on Hinduism or not. I have spent 11 years exploring Hinduism and I have learned a lot. And it's been my great fortune that I've learned at the feet of an enlightened master. So what I'm sharing is something which I really feel is important to clear the confusion of Hindus. You can cheat yourself all you want about saying this is Hinduism, that is Hinduism. But the problem is not just about you diluting about what is Hinduism and what is not Hinduism. Problem is you are cheating yourself. You're cheating yourself by somehow consoling yourself that you're a Hindu because you like some aspects of Hinduism. But you're also not ready to take the next step forward in your journey. And that's bad for you. That's not just bad for me or bad for Hinduism. It's bad for you. It's denying your possibilities. How can you get enlightened if you don't believe in enlightenment? How can you find somebody to show you the next step if you don't believe in the next step? Right? So this is all I have to say. And it's a very hot debate, which, you know, generally keeps going around. And I also want to say I don't hate atheists. I don't have any personal, you know, vengeance against atheists or something. But it is important for at least atheists to understand that they are not, able to grasp many things which people like me share. And it is because they are defining themselves only to their logic. It is just a humble, sincere request that, you should explore a little bit more before forming judgments about people like me. Because that is like, when you form a judgment about people like me, you're setting barriers between people like me and people like you. So, jisko bolte na adan pradan of knowledge, of experiences cannot happen that way. Anyway, thank you.